Today marks 4 days since the legislators led by Theodore Sechikubo, the Member of Parliament for Remiaga County, initiated the impeachment process for the four parliamentary commissioners. This follows allegations that they awarded themselves public funds amounting to 1.7 billion Uganda shillings. The embattled commissioners are Matthias Mpuga, Prosim Babazi Akampurira, Esther Afoyochan, and Solomon Siluanyi. Honorable Sarah Opendi, one of the instigators of the impeachment process, has revealed that there are reports of a section of legislators who are planning to hide the signatures that have been gathered so far. She said this matter has been reported to police. Opendi said over 30 legislators have so far signed on the impeachment document. She added that the MPs have been cooperative on this matter. Honorable Sechikubo was seen getting signatures from different members of parliament at a table that he had stationed at the entrance of the plenary. He said that he is optimistic more members will sign up. Sechikubo and his team commenced the impeachment process on Tuesday in an effort they termed redeeming the image of parliament. The Uganda Human Rights Commission, led by Mariam Falzato Wangadia, have today handed over to Speaker of Parliament Anita Among an annual report highlighting the soaring child rights abuses in the country. The report indicates that out of the 14,846 cases that were reported to police last year, 12,771 are the cases of defilement, among other human rights abuses. Among other human rights abuses highlighted in the report is the use of the bucket system as a toilet facility in prison cells. The commission also highlighted the loss of lives of juveniles due to hunger in remand homes.
Lack of transport and lack of access to beddings also remained a challenge in many detention facilities, particularly police stations and posts. During the period in issue, we conducted human rights education activities targeting duty bearers and rights holders in the formal and informal sectors.
On receiving the report, Speaker Anita Among appreciated the efforts of the commission and issued assurance that government will study the report with intent and act on the recommendations therein.
And as Parliament of Uganda, we are very grateful that you've cited an issue on bills. We'll ensure that we have always public engagement whenever we are making a bill, that all the bills we should be having consultation, and we will always ensure that we consult the public because the end users of these bills.
Animal theft in Bale district is frustrating government efforts towards fighting animal poverty. The concern was raised by the special enterprising grant for older persons beneficiaries, who called upon the security organs to step up their efforts to curb the vice. The state minister for the elderly, Dominic Gidudu, said the animals that are being stolen from the elderly need to be compensated by insurers. He recommended that the beneficiaries take advantage of the insurers that would be able to cover the gap of the stolen animals. Minister Gidudu and his council are currently in Elgon region monitoring the progress of PDM, SEGOP and SEG programs.
You must think ahead of them. That's number one. Number two, there's what we call agricultural insurance, where government pays 80%, you pay 20. Whatever money they get, let them also get agricultural insurance. What you do, connect yourself to means of finance, agricultural insurance. It's not a lot of money. Because they can steal, they can fall sick.
The chairperson for the National Council for Older Persons has urged the beneficiaries to embrace the programs and invest in viable business enterprises.
Why the government has decided to send this IPF to the districts is for you people to determine the enterprise, this advise them, the enterprise they are going to take and do something.
He asked local leaders to rally the population to embrace the parish development model, which he described as a game changer.